The once majestic Airbus A320, now devoid of engines, wings and landing gear, is about to say goodbye to its flight deck.
There's not a huge amount holding it on at the moment. You've got a small bit of floor structure, small bit of the crown, and then 5 points from where we've cut the frames underneath the floor.
Heavy-duty strops are lashed through the window cavities. Cuts will now be made to separate the cockpit and fuselage. Both can be sold on to the growing aviation salvage market, where savvy designers can turn them into everything from garden sheds to fitted wardrobes.
We'll cut the floor, we'll cut the crown, and then we'll jump out and nip the final frames in.
Cue angle grinder Ace Perry.
It might be a bit wobbly, but you're surprised how strong that floor is because it's composite. It's really strong.
So we've got the 5 points left now holding it on. Nip them, and hopefully she'll come away clean. Hopefully. Remember to put the ropes on now, please.
And that'll be it. Won't be long.
She's putting the guide ropes on now just so that I've got control of the load when it does come away.
The final cut, and the plane should be free to separate.
All right. Let's have a go then, is it? Let's jump
but
out
as the away. Moment of reckoning arrives, it looks like the plane isn't ready to come apart.
Take it up to about a ton, and we'll see if it moves.
There's a problem. So what could be causing a hold-up?
Hold the rope a minute where it is. Let me have a little look. I don't want it to flip if the weight comes off. If something's holding the flight deck or whatever sort of load that we're lifting is under stress and it does sort of pop, the load could then sort of go where I don't want it to go. I like to be in control of it. I want to know where it's going and where I want it to put it. Little things as it starts to sort of break away, I like to get up there and make sure that we're 100% clear that everything's out of the way, and then we can move the lift when I'm happy then. It's a tie wrap.
It's one tiny plastic tie wrap holding the flight deck in place and endangering the whole operation.
All right, call him up. Okay. Right, you want the nose to face here so we can pick it up. But slowly, slowly.
Finally, she's airborne. The 1.2 tons of flight deck raised into the sky.
Here you are, Carl. Right, coming down! There we are.
And the Eagle has landed.
Nice job on the rope back. This will be coming off the yard probably within the next hour, out of the way, getting blanked up, weatherproofed, and then off to its customer.
And who's that customer? Someone who wants to turn it into a garden shed. The Airbus A320 is now a shadow of its former self. Resembling the carcass of a beached whale, it lies ready for the crusher. The seats have gone on to be refurbished for a new plane. Cockpit is at the bottom of somebody's garden, and all that's left is for the main fuselage to be put to use.
3 o'clock, we've got 1 hour to get the rear section off. I think it's feasible, and I'm hoping that we get a nice, nice tea break after this now. So, hopefully everything goes nice.
Everyone on the team knows exactly what's needed to pull this challenge off.
Strops are going up, OK? Just to take them out of the way of the cut line. Happy days. Let's go for it.
Chicken gets stuck in, and it looks as though he's going to set some sort of a record. But it's hard work, and they need plenty of rest breaks as they take it in turns to do the cutting. Chicken has certainly earned his rest. And with all the chopping done, it's time to lift out the cut fuselage.
Happy? If we're happy, we'll all jump down. There's no need to be up here then. Doon, please, Captain. Right, we'll put it next to where Adam just walked.
I just want to cut them up and get rid of them and get the new planes in, cut them up. So, in and out, that's our motto. Hold on a minute, I'm going to move it forward a bit, all right?
That has got to go a minute. Over there. we free? I can't see.
The lads on the base worked at breakneck speed to get the plane ready for a scrapping slot that had become unexpectedly available. And as the mechanical mashers move in, what's left of the plane gets torn to shreds, and Chicken can barely contain his glee.
I've seen them go down smoother, put it that way, but it's off, so, yeah. We've started, we've finally started.
It may look like carnage, but there's method to this madness. Even though the planes are getting broken up, the skill is to make sure none of the ancillary equipment that's needed for reuse gets mashed up with them. And, as always, it's safety first.
It's happened in the past, minor damage to aircraft that we need to save because they're not ours. The customer still wants them here, and the cages and the acros have sometimes been damaged as well. So my role is to keep an eye on these and just make sure that things are going as they should be. I'm going to jump on the forklift a minute. I only go in there when the drivers can see me. If they can't, I'll beep my horn and make sure that they're aware. It's just to get the little things like the cages and the tail steadies out.
Now let's give it some to the wings. Then the bulk of the airframe.
Very loud here at the moment. They've definitely got into it with everything they can. The front end and the rear end has all fallen off now. It's pretty much just the center section with two little wing stubs poking out, and that's pretty much all that's left at the moment. I think it's, like boys and their toys. I mean, it's big, it's loud, it's dangerous. Most people would like to be driving the machines, I think, to be honest. First aircraft, which was right in the middle of the yard, has been removed off the sleepers. It's not damaged any of the aircraft or anything that we need to keep. And they'll chomp away at this now and then move on to the next 320 so we can get the new 320 in its place as soon as possible. Hopefully it'll be in the truck soon and it'll be off up country.
So the big question is, did Chicken and his crew set an on-site record?
As far as demolitions go, that was one of the fastest we've had. So on to the next one.